If two circles intersect at two points, prove that their centers lie on the perpendicular bisector of the common chord. Given two circles with centers O and O dash intersect at A and B. C is the midpoint of AB. We have to prove angle OC O dash is equal to 180 degree, that is O and O dash lie on the line O O dash. For that we have to construct, and the construction will be, we have to join OA, O dash A, OB and O dash B. Now proof. Triangle OAO dash is congruent to triangle OBO dash. Here OA is equal to OB, radii of the same circle. O dash A is equal to O dash B, radii of the same circle. OO dash common. So these two triangles are congruent by SSS rule. This implies that angle AOO dash is equal to angle A is equal to angle BOO dash CPCT. AOO dash is equal to BOO dash. Now triangle AOC and triangle BOC are congruent by side angle side. OC is common. Therefore, triangle AOC is congruent to triangle BOC. The region is SAS, side angle side rule. This implies that angle ACO is equal to angle BCO CPCT. ACO and BCO are linear pair of angles. So angle ACO plus angle BCO is equal to 180 degree. This implies that angle ACO is equal to angle BCO is equal to 90 degree. Region linear pair axiom. Similarly, we can prove triangle AC O dash is congruent to triangle BC O dash. Then angle ACO is called, angle ACO dash is equal to angle BCO dash is equal to 90 degree. Angle ACO dash is equal to angle BCO dash is equal to 90 degree. Now angle ACO plus angle ACO dash is equal to 90 degree. plus 90 degree, which is equal to 180 degree. Angle ACO plus angle ACO dash means angle OCO dash. So angle OCO dash is equal to 180 degree. This implies that angle OCO dash is equal to 180 degree. Hence, proved. Question number 2. Two circles of radii 5 cm and 3 cm intersect at two points, and the distance between their centers is 4 cm. Find the length of the common chord. Solution. In the given diagram, here OA is equal to 5 cm, O dash A is equal to 3 cm. O dash is equal to 4 cm. We have to find the length of common chord AB. For that, let OC is equal to X cm. Then O dash C is equal to OC is X cm. O dash is 4 cm. So O dash C is 4 minus X. 4 minus X cm. Now we know that the line joining the centers of two intersecting circles is the perpendicular bisector of the common chord. This implies that in right triangle ACO and triangle ACO dash by Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to AO square minus OC square, and AC square is equal to AO dash square minus O dash C square. This implies that AO square minus OC square. Here AO is 5, OC is X, is equal to AO dash whole square minus O dash C whole square. AO dash is 3 and O dash C is 4 minus X. These both are equal to AC square, so they are equal. 25 minus X square, 9. A minus B whole square, A square minus 2AB, 2 into 4 into X, at X plus B square. This implies that 25 minus X square, 9 minus 16 plus at X minus X square. Now minus X square is cancelled from both sides. Then here we have 9 minus 16 minus 7 plus 8X is equal to 25. Then we have 8X is equal to 25 minus 7 goes to other side. This is 32. From here we have x is equal to 32 by 8. This implies that x is equal to 32 by 8, which is 4. Therefore, AC square is equal to, which is 5 square minus x square, is equal to 25 minus 16, which is 9 centimeter square. This implies that AC is equal to 3 centimeter. Now 2AC is equal to 6 centimeter. This implies that AB is equal to 6 centimeter. Here 2AC is equal to AB, why? Perpendicular from the center to the chord. Bisect the chord. Now question number 3. If two equal chords of a circle intersect within the circle, prove that the segments of one chord are equal to corresponding segments of the other chord. Here segment means part. Solution. Given in circle COR equal chords AB and CD intersect each other at E. We have to prove corresponding segments. For AE, corresponding segment is CE, and for BE, corresponding segment is DE. Here equal chords are given, and we know that equal chords are equidistant from the center, so we have to construct. To construct draw OM perpendicular to AB and ON perpendicular to CD. Now proof. We have to also join OE. Now if we make equal ME and NE, then we can show AE is equal to CE. For that, we have to also make equal CN and AM. And from CN, we subtract NE, and from AM, we subtract ME. Then we get AE is equal to CE. So let us proceed. AB is equal to CD. It is given. Now, two half AB is equal to half CD. Half AB is equal to, we can write AM. And half CD is equal to, we can write CN. Perpendicular from the center to a chord. Bisect the chord. So half of AB is equal to AM. This is equation 1. Now we have to equate ME and NE. Here OM is equal to ON. Because equal chords are equidistant from the center. These two triangles are right triangle. This hypotenuse is common. So the triangle OME and triangle ONE, angle OME is equal to angle ONE, each 90 degree. OE is equal to OE. Hypotenuse and it is common. And OM is equal to ON. Equal chords are equidistant. Right, are equidistant. This implies that triangle OME is congruent to triangle ONE. The reason is RHS rule, right angle hypotenuse side. This implies that ME is equal to NE, CPCT. This is equation 2. From 1, AM is equal to CN. This implies that AM is AE plus ME and CN is CE plus NE. AE plus ME, CN is CE plus NE. This implies that AE plus ME is equal to CE plus ME. Here NE is equal to ME from equation 2. NE is equal to ME. Now we can write AE is equal to CE. M is cancelled from both sides. Here M is subtracted from equals. If equals are subtracted from equals, then the remainders are equal by Euclid's axiom. So first proved. Now we have to prove BE is equal to DE. So we will write AB is equal to CD. It is given half of AB is equal to half of CD, Euclid's axiom. Then half AB can be written as BM and half CD can be written as DN. So BM is equal to DN. Now we add ME to both sides. Then BM plus ME is equal to DN plus ME, and ME can be written as NE from equation 2. Then we have B is equal to DE. AB is equal to CD implies that half AB is equal to half CD, implies that BM is equal to DN. Now we add ME to both sides. We know by Euclid's axiom, if equals are added to equals, then wholes are equal. Here BM is equal to DN, ME is equal to ME, the wholes are equal. So this is by Euclid's axiom. From here we have BM plus ME is BE and DN plus ME can be written as NE from 2. So we have BE is equal to DE. So second proved. Three girls, Reshma, Salma and Mandeep, are playing a game by standing on a circle of radius 5 meter drawn in a park. रेशमा थ्रोज अ बॉल टू सलमा, सलमा टू मनदीप, मनदीप टू रेशमा. इफ द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन रेशमा एंड सलमा एंड बिटवीन सलमा एंड मनदीप इज 6 meters ईच, व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन रेशमा एंड मनदीप? लेट अस ड्रॉ द डायग्राम. सॉल्यूशन, लेट आर एस एंड एम डिनोट द गर्ल्स रेशमा सलमा एंड मनदीप रिस्पेक्टिवली. देन वी हैव आर एस इज इक्वल टू एस एम इज इक्वल टू 6 meters. वी हैव टू फाइंड आर एम. ऑल्सो ज्वाइन ओ आर एंड ओ एस. ओ एस इंटरसेक्ट्स आर एम एट पी. यू विल हैव टू ड्रॉ परपेंडिकुलर ऑन आर एस ऑल्सो. सपोज दिस इज क्यू, सो ज्वाइन ओ आर ओ एस ओ एम एंड ड्रॉ ओ क्यू परपेंडिकुलर टू आर एस. फॉर फाइंडिंग आर एम वी हैव टू फाइंड आर पी. देन वी मल्टीप्लाई आर पी विथ टू. बट बिफोर दैट वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट ओ पी इज परपेंडिकुलर टू आर एम. सो द एरिया ऑफ ट्रेंगल ओ आर एस कैन बी फाउंड इन टू वेज. वन वे इज हाफ इंटू आर एस इंटू ओ क्यू. हियर ओ क्यू विल बी, इट इज गिवेन ओ एस इज इक्वल टू 5 meters. It is radius and it is 5 meters. Here OS is equal to 5 meters. And the perpendicular from the center to a chord bisects to the chord, so QS is equal to 3 meters. So we can find OQ. In this way we have the area of RS. And the another way to find the area is half into RP into OS. Here OS is 5 and RP is taken as X. Firstly we prove OP is perpendicular to RM. Triangle ORS is congruent to triangle OMS. You can see OR is equal to OM. And RS is equal to SM, it is given. OS is equal to OS, it is common. So these two triangles are congruent by side rule. This implies that angle ROP is equal to angle MOP by CPCT. Therefore triangle ROP is congruent to triangle. This angle becomes equal to this angle. So these two triangles are congruent by side angle side. OP is common in both triangle. This implies that angle RPO is equal to angle MPO CPCT. Now RPO and MPO make linear pair of angles and they are equal, so each of them will be 90 degrees. So angle RPO is equal to 90. This implies that RP is perpendicular to OS. bilinear pair axiom. Now area of triangle ORS. Therefore area of triangle ORS is equal to half into base. If you take base OS, then corresponding height will be RP. Then OS is 5 meter, it is given. So 5 by 2 RP. This is equation 1. Now OQ is perpendicular to RS. So QS is equal to half of 6 meter, because perpendicular from the center to a chord bisects the chord. QS is equal to RS by 2. The reason is OQ is perpendicular to RS. This implies that 6 meter by 2 is 3 meter. Now by Pythagoras theorem in right triangle OQS, we can find OQ. OQ will be a square root of OS square minus QS square. In right triangle OQS, by Pythagoras theorem, we have OQ is equal to a square root of OS square minus QS square. OS is 5 and QS is 3. 25 minus 9, 16. A square root of 16 is, so OQ is 4 meter. Therefore, area of triangle ORS is equal to half into base. If we take base as RS, then its corresponding height will be OQ. So half into RS into OQ. It is given RS is 6 and OQ is obtained here 4. We have 12 meter square. This is the area of triangle ORS. From 1 and 2, we have from 1, area of triangle ORS is equal to 5 by 2 RP. 5 by 2 RP is equal to 12. From here we have RP is equal to 2 into 12, 24 by 5. We have to find RM. So we multiply both sides by 2. Then we have 48 by 5. Now 2 RP is equal to RM. Here after division with 5, we have 9.6 meter. Hence the required distance is